Hey guys, welcome back. So today in this video, we will talk about how you can send notification when the data is changed in Firebase database. So guys, as you can see on the screen that this is a edit text, and if I will write a demo name, Rajan Sharma, and after this, when I will click on the button save name. So as you can see that here a data child is created, user, and inside this is my name, and there is also a notification. You can see that bell icon, and when I will open this, so you can see that Rajan Sharma, thank you for registration. So how you can do this, how you can achieve this? So whenever if I will change this name, and I will write any other name like codes pair, then codes pair, then what will happen guys, that when I will again click on the save name, then you can see again that there is a notification and the data here is changed. So how you can do this, you can see that codes pair, thank you for registration. So in this video I will show you how you can do this in your Android app. Whenever the data will change in the Firebase real-time database, then it will push notification to the user. So let's start. So guys, first of all we will create activity main.xml file. So as you can see on the screen, this is our XML file. So simply change our root layout from constant layout to linear layout. And its orientation will be vertical. Orientation vertical, and gravity center. So here we will use one edit text with 300 dp height, wrap content, hint, name, id, name, et, then text size, text size 20 sp, text color Android black, and done. And after this we will use a simply button, and with wrap content, height wrap content, text, save, name, id, btn, save, done. So now our XML file is complete. So it's time to go to mainactivity.java. So here first of all we have to create another class, and for our getter and setter methods, so simply give it a name member, and then after click OK. And here we will define some strings, so private string name, and after this create a empty constructor for saving data in real-time database. And then simply here click on write, and then go to generate, and then getter and setter methods, then control plus A, and then okay. So guys, now our main activity, I mean member.java class is complete. So it's time to give reference. So simply write edit text, edit text, and then button, btn, and after this we will write integer. So we are using it because of some reason, so give it value 0, and I will explain it later. Firebase database, database, database reference, then reference, and last one is member, member. So now we declared all the variables. It's time to give reference. So first of all write member equals to new member, and then btn equals to find view by id, r dot id dot btn save, and then edit text equals to find view by id, r dot id dot name et, and then after this we will write reference equals to database dot get instance, get instance dot get reference dot child, and we will give it name user. And then here we will write reference dot add on child list, then new, and then child event listener. Then again write reference and dot add value event listener, and then new value event listener. So inside this value event listener, so guys, as you can see on the screen that we are using add value event listener and add child event listener. So first of all, we will code inside add value event listener. So here we will use if statement, that if data snapshot dot exist, then id that we have used, it is an integer. So what it will do when the user changes the data again and again, then it will increment that data in database. So simply write int, and then inside this integer, and then data snapshot dot get children count, and then so after this come inside it, and now what here we have to do is on child added. So inside this what we will write, we will simply use this if statement. So first of all, we have to define a string, then simply write string name equals to edit text dot get text dot to string, and then inside this we will write to if name equals to is empty, then we will show a toast message that toast dot make text get application context, then message please fill, and then again toast dot length long dot show. So and in else condition we will write that else notification. Now it is showing error because we have not created that method yet, but I will create it. So after writing it, simply go outside it, and then here we have to use btn. Simply write btn dot set on click listener, then new, then on click listener, and inside this we will write again, we will use a if statement, again write string name equals to edit text dot get text dot to string, and then again here we will use if statement, if name dot is empty, then we will show the toast again to copy this line, Ctrl plus C, and then go inside it is empty, then we will show this toast, and else then what we will do is simply write member dot set name, then edit text dot get text dot to string, and then after this we will write reference dot child string dot value of id plus 1. So as you can see that it will increment the data whenever the user changes the data again and again. So then after this write dot set value member. So guys, this is our how our data will save. It is done. So now after this we have to create our method. So guys, now we will create our method. Simply write private and then void notification that we have given there, and inside this method what we will write is Here again we have to define, so guys, as you can see that this is notification method, and so what we have to do is simply we have to create a channel for showing notification. So how can we do this is simply write if and then build, oops, if then build dot version dot SDK int is smaller than or equals to build dot version codes zero. So if your build version is codes, I mean it will compare this condition and notification channel. After this we will write notification channel and then channel equals to new notification channel, and here we will give it ID n, and then again we will write n, and then here we will give notification manager. So don't get confused because it is not depreciated, it is by mistake showing it is depreciated, but it will not give any error while running. Then after this write importance default, and then again notification manager equals to get system service then notification manager dot class, and then inside you'll write manager dot create notification channel, then pass that string channel, so variable channel. After now here we have to write notification compat builder, notification compat dot builder, and then again builder equals to new notification dot builder, and then we will write here this, and then again n. So you have to write the same name that you have given here. So as you can see that our ID is n and name is n, so here we have to give that channel ID. So this is our channel ID n, so we have to give the same ID here. So that is how it will automatically recognize the channel. Then after this write set content title, so we will give it a name, code spare, then again dot set small icon, so here r dot drawable, oops, r dot drawable dot IC notifications. So this is an icon which I have already pasted in my drawable file, so you can do this. And after this write dot set auto cancel, pass it true, and then dot set content text. So here we will write data, new data is added, so new data is added, and then after this we will write notification manager compat, notification manager compat, then manager compat is equal to notification manager compat dot from this, and last thing that manager compat dot notify, then inside this we will write let me change this notify, and inside this we will write 999, then builder dot build. So guys, now our coding part is almost complete. So now what we have to do is simply run the Android app and see if there is any kind of error or not. So it's time to wake up Sam, my Android emulator, and let's see what will happen. So in case if you get any error, then let me know in comment section. And for source code, follow and DM me on Instagram, and my account's link will be in the description. So I can give you source code, you can directly message me. Let me open Firebase real-time database. So guys, as you can see that this is my new project CodeSphere that I have connected because the old one Firebase is so old. So I recently created a new project of name CodeSphere. So guys, as you can see that our app is now running successfully. So if I will write here some name, then what will happen that when I will click on the button save name and see what will happen. So guys, as you can see that the child user is created here, and the name Rajan Sharma is saved here, and we also got the notification. So as you can see that it is notification CodeSphere new data is added. And when I will clear this, and when I will again change this data, and here I will write code, here I will write subscribe my channel, and when I will again click save name, so as you can see that we got the notification here and the data is added successfully. So subscribe my channel, and you can see that notification, and I think it's working absolutely fine. And the if statement, that if the edit text is empty and still someone click on that button, then it will show notification please fill. It will not send notification, it will show a toast message, sorry, please fill. So you can also show the name of user in the notification. So how can we do this is simply go inside our notification method, and here we have to define some string name equals to edit text dot get text dot to string, and again here string user. So give it a message equals to thank you for registration, and then here what you have to do is inside this set content text simply write name plus message. Now again run the Android app and see that is it working or not. Guys, now again our app is running successfully. So open Firebase real-time database, and I will again write here Sam, and when I will click save name, so guys, as you can see that child is created here, and see that the name is showing or not. So guys, as you can see that it is showing Sam, thank you for registration. So this is all for this tutorial. If you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe my channel, and make sure you press the bell icon for future tutorials, because I will upload more interesting videos like this. Thank you for watching.